So, welcome to my June 2017 calendar. So I'll be honest, I'm not in, you know, life is tough right now, so, you know, or whatever, so I might not sound as jolly as I usually do, but, you know, I couldn't think of a better time to record my calendar. I really wish that I could be in a better mood, and I'm sorry about that, but, yeah, so, this is my June 2017 calendar, and it's Guardians of the Galaxy, Volume 1, not Volume 2. I hadn't done Volume 2. I wasn't able to do Volume 2 because I have to do Volume 1 first, but, you know, it didn't really matter because, you know. So, I decided, because I thought it would be fun to do Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 1. So, basically, Guardians of the Galaxy, it came out in 2014. So, my mom and sister, actually, younger sister, saw this movie in August before we did, and me and my brother, and so they didn't like it, but me and my brother watched it. I actually really did like it. Okay, so Guardians of the Galaxy, well, you know, I hesitated on doing this because, there was a few reasons. Okay, so Guardians of the Galaxy is Marvel Cinematic Universe. Okay, so, you know, it being Marvel Cinematic Universe and all, it, like, is part of Marvel Cinematic Universe. But the thing is, Guardians of the Galaxy is so good that even though, okay, I don't know, you probably know about the Infinity War, coming up. If you don't, then don't look it up if you don't want to know about it. But, you know, the Guardians of the Galaxy is, like, the biggest step to the Infinity War in Marvel Cinematic Universe. But the most interesting thing about it is that, unlike most Marvel Cinematic Universe films, so a lot of Marvel Cinematic Universe films feel like they're building up to something, and even though Guardians of the Galaxy was the biggest build-up in the entire Marvel Cinematic Universe probably so far, like, it just seemed like its own thing. It didn't feel like it was building up. It felt like it was Guardians of the Galaxy, and that's what it was like. It wasn't depending on the other Marvel films to, like, its own quality wasn't in the other Marvel Cinematic Universe films. It just felt like it was a good film all by itself that, you know, you could enjoy this film without having to watch any of the other films, you know? And it's just a good film all by itself. Okay, of course there's some language and stuff that it's not fun. And yeah, it's, at times it gets a little rougher than I would have liked. Well, not rougher, but like, well, whatever you call it. But yeah, Guardians of the Galaxy, it just, in its own way, it, like, you know, it feels like its very own film that isn't dependent on the other films, and even though it's the biggest step. And it's fun, there's a lot of humor, even though some of the humor I don't like, but, you know, a lot of the humor is still funny, you know, like beating up grass, which I don't have a picture for, but is still, you know, part of the story, you know, and it's just sort of funny at times. It's just out there, and it stands on its own, and yeah. Let's see. What else should I say? It just feels unique. So, it's Guardians of the Galaxy. And so the reason I waited so long to do this was I just wanted it to seem like, you know, the reason I was doing this, I didn't want the reason I did this calendar to be as part of Marvel Cinematic Universe. Like, I wasn't gonna have this as a prerequisite to Infinity War. I was gonna make, because, you know, just how it stands out on its own, I wasn't gonna go like, well, this has to be done before others, because I didn't want this one to be a stress at all. Like, the only one this would be prerequisite for would be the second Guardians of the Galaxy. So I was like, yeah, this will only be a prerequisite to the second one. And still, I was like, I don't want to make it feel like I'm making this just because of the second one. So I can do the second. So, you know, I was considering doing it for May, but I was like, yeah, I want to do this just because I want to do it. And so, you know, once the second one came out, I was like, Yeah, I was like, why do it for May? I didn't want to feel like I had to do it just for the second one. So, you know, it was in May that I was like, yeah, this seems like it would work for June. And yeah, I just wanted to do it because I wanted to do it, not because I felt like I had to, like I have with some other Marvel Cinematic Universe calendars. Like, you know, I wanted this to stand on its own. Not have to be there just, you know, to work with the others. And so, yeah, that's why it took me a while to make this, because I was waiting for the time when I would feel like I could do it on my own, or just do it just for fun, and yeah, that's what it came down to, even though the second one just came out, and you know, that was like, but you know, I had nothing else to do, sort of. Maybe you're gonna go like, oh, now what's he gonna do in the future? I don't know. There's some ideas I have, but you know, there's some things that I still can do, and want to do and you know prerequisites to or postrequisites to finish up, so there's still stuff to do, other calendars to make. You might see a lot of weird stuff in the future. I don't know for sure because I haven't completely ran out of ideas yet for calendars, and there's still quite a few left to do. Just, you know, some of the stuff I've put on the back burner might be up soon. And I got a text, and so I'm gonna read the text view now. It's from my mom. Songs 11, 12, 6, in that order. Oh, my mom is telling me what songs to do for Guardians of the Galaxy calendar in the background. So, 11, 12, and 6. Ooh, I should look that up. Okay, central casting. Okay. Let's see. Yeah. No, don't want any of this. Okay, Guardians of the Galaxy soundtrack. Yeah, you're probably hearing this music, so you're probably like, ugh, this is weird. So, 11, 12, and 6, right? Okay, so... Oh, child. No, not that one yet. Ain't no mountain high enough, and then... Okay. I can't do that in that order, because then that might mess up the order. But yeah, those are... You know, I will definitely consider that. And this is central casting, and so I'll go back to my calendar. So yeah. The design was going to be a special color, because, you know, it's something I barely ever do. Purple. So, it's like, you know, Guardians of the Galaxy gave me a perfect opportunity to do purple in the calendar. And so, you'll see. It's not all purple, and so, you know, I'll show you the whole block of whatever. And, why isn't it moving? That was weird. So I'm moving this, and it wasn't all purple, it sort of fades to blue, sort of like the poster, or my DVD case, but you know, it's sort of purple, and it fades to blue, there's a little bit of alternating colors, and then, oh wow, so you know, this side has purple on it, this side has blue, and I'll undo that, and it's a little longer, so you know, and it alternates better when it's longer like that. So yeah. And you'll also notice there's actually a pretty cool vision I had for this. And so what I basically did was, okay, so purple. Purple is more of bluish red. Well, this side is just plain blue. So I was thinking, well, okay, so if this side's bluer and this side's purpler, then this side would have more blue stars, and this side would have more red stars. I mean, not more red stars, but it'd be like, you know, off and on, of blue and purple. I mean, blue and red stars on this side. Well, this one would be mostly blue stars. And then that got me thinking, okay, so in astronomy, I know that, like, blue stars are newer, you know, younger stars that are, like, burning brighter. They're, like, big stars. They have a lot of energy and stuff. Well, the red stars are the stars that are sort of dying out and stuff. you know, they've burned all their hydrogen. And it's a sad thought, but, you know, I realize that over here on the purple side would be older space, while over here on the blue side would be newer space. And so, also on the older space, there's a smaller density of stars than on the bluer space. So, you know, the older space is sort of, you know, there's still blue stars, but it's like the density is not as intense as on this side. It was also hard to get a balance because it needed to transition, but, like, you'll see on this side there's not as many stars as on this side. And so, yeah. So, there's small dots. I'll show you a close-up. They're actually, like, star shapes I got on the calendar. Sort of starry. But yeah. So, that was pretty cool. How it sort of transitions. Hopefully. And here you'll see that there's actually planets. Okay, so I actually, this is actually pretty cool. Because, you know, here in the center picture, you'll see that right here is, you know, just a planet on the edge of this picture. Well, I was thinking about putting planets in the calendar. So what I did was I decided that this would be a starter. So, in a way, like, I decided that the picture would sort of fade out onto this right here. So it would look like there's all one planet. I hope it transitions well. So it looks like this is an overlaying, like, texture to the planet that you see here. So, yeah, it's sort of more fancy and everything. And, the picture here has better graphics. But, you know, this one is, like, sort of like, you know, it's overlapping. You know, like, this one fades out. This is, like, an extra layer. This one is less of a layer, I guess. So, yeah. And then there's also other planets. And I also realized that in this picture, there was going to be the sun. There's no sun in the actual picture, but from the picture, you could tell where the light's coming from. It's, like, coming from this side of the planet on the other side. So, I tried to get that sunlight beam to, like, sort of, it would affect how these other planets, this red planet, this yellow planet, and this green planet, how the sun would be shining off of those planets. So, yeah, how the light would be hitting it. I'm hoping that these are orbiting. Yeah, that could be a good orbit. They're all above the sun, though. That's a really weird orbit, but I don't know. But, you know, they're sort of within line of each other. The pictures are sort of affected. Their lighting, the shadows on the edges, are sort of affected by how the light's hitting them. Sort of. I'm not that perfected at that. And even these text boxes, you know, each box is affected by a different angle of how the light would be hitting it, sort of. So there's 15 degrees between each picture of the light source. So, yeah. So 15 degrees difference of how the light's hitting each of these sort of affect how it would look. But I'm trying not to reveal what's happening so soon. But yeah, that's how it is. And, you know. And then here on this planet, I decided to put a ring. It's not the best ring ever because, you know, it's just not. Because that's how rings are. So, you know, it's not exactly like a ring probably should look. Yeah, it's a little, whatever. And then on this planet, there's another, but it's gonna be really hard to close in on that. Okay, so the text font I chose is sort of like, you know, it looks spacey. I was like, maybe that's a little bit too cliche, you know, for spacey, because I've probably used that a lot before. But then I realized that this is Guardians of the Galaxy. you know, 80s music and stuff. So it, like, just has this 80s feel to it. So it's like, if it's the 80s, then, like, you know, why wouldn't I use some sort of 80s text font for spacey? So, you know, traditional. And that's what I decided. And it was sort of hard. What happened to the text font? That should not disappear like that. There. It just disappeared for a second. And there's the shadow hair. I tried to get it closely matching. It was hard, but I tried to get it closely matching the Guardians of the Galaxy text hair. At one point, I had it this color as this, but it was, like, too bright. And, you know, I decided to switch it up to this way. So it's close to that. I actually used a certain tool that this came with, which you can select it from text fill and sample font color, you know, and then it gave me in these recent colors here because, you know, I had to use a fading kind of font. So, yeah. So let's see. How should we do the pictures? Let's start in the middle. Since the sun's inside this picture, you know, the sunlight is reflecting on all the sides of this picture. This is a poster that you might see for Guardians of the Galaxy. It shows all your heroes fighting side by side from the studio that brought you the Avengers. And probably part of the universe. There's also his ship hair. That's how it is. So here's a rocket firing, and all these characters are just fighting, and I am Groot. And, you know, it's just friendly. You know, they're all fighting and they're friendly. I don't know how that is. And then here is a picture. Oh, that's probably too soon. Here is a picture that starts off the movie. It's Star-Lord, you know, dancing around, singing, wondering if I should put this music. I don't know. But yeah. He's, like, dancing around with a rat singing. And he's the only one who can hear it. So this rat is, like, on the Stranger Planet. And some guy comes up singing, lip-singing a song that only he can hear. So, poor rat kind of creature. And then, yeah, I'll go the other way. I'll go opposite direction this time. And then here we have the dark thing, and Star-Lord's looking at all the fighting going on from his ship, and he's going to help. So yeah. Here is Star-Lord and Rocket Raccoon. They're fighting side by side, in Nowhere, which is, the severed head of a celestial being. Celestial being, yeah, you know, sort of gives you a hint. Okay, if you don't get the reference, then, you know, someday you might. Are you a huge fan of these movies? Then maybe you will someday. I'm getting a drink of water. So, yeah. Totally informal. Yeah, I'm totally informal. That's awesome, huh? And then here we have the lady whose name I am uncomfortable saying because it's one of the cities that was destroyed in the Bible during Lot's time, and her sister Nebula. I get confused between Nova and Nebula. I was like, I might as well get a picture of Nebula in this calendar sometime or another. And so I was like, yeah, even though it's only the back of her head, so. But you know, I had to get a picture of her eventually. And then here is Star-Lord flying through space listening to my mom's least favorite song. Yeah. But it's Star-Lord's mom's favorite song. I'm just saying, because my mom's least favorite song, Star-Lord's mom's favorite song, it only makes sense. So yeah. Star-Lord and his mom. Oh yeah, the stars you might notice have a glow to them also. It sort of gives them a texture. You know, like the stars, or the fireflies from the Good Dinosaur calendar that my brother so loved. Oh, man. I need to talk to him about the good dinosaur. No, not really. He's never gonna listen. He doesn't like the good dinosaur. That's his life. The good dinosaur's okay. And this is about Guardians of the Galaxy, not about good dinosaur. That reminds me about, Theorizer roasting himself. And so that ended up becoming a roast of another topic, and yeah, about others. And so that's how it is. And I don't know why it's called roasting. I guess, like, cooking stuff. This is totally off topic. So yeah. And that's how it is. Guardians of the Galaxy and Star-Lord flying through space, his hands totally exposed to the spacey stuff. And here is when he's completely exposed, more than just his hands, to space, because he put the mask on the lady, because he felt super heroic. And so Yondu's coming. I didn't get any pictures of Yondu this time, sorry. You Yondu fans. But he had to save her life, because he knew she wouldn't make it out there. And so, yeah, he called Yondu to save him. He would die in seconds, so hopefully he survives. Here is a scene that is so sad, because we are Groot. So Groot creates fireflies and a cocoon. We are Groot. And here is another moving scene. Grab my hand. It sort of reflects his own mother, you know, like, his mother said, grab my hand, and I don't know why this background's here, but it looks super awesome, and so I decided to keep it, and, you know, I decided that would be the coolest, and so, it gives an emotional outlook as his mother says, grab my hand, and then the lady says, grab my hand at the same time, and he remembers how he didn't grab his mother's hand. I'm spoiling the movie, so hopefully you have seen it. Or you don't care. And then here is another crazy thing, where they're basically lifting off. Oh yeah, you'll notice that on this side, the pictures are more reddish-colory than the other side, which are more bluey, I hope. So yeah. That was what I tried to capture. I don't know if I did a good job at that. But, you know. So here is, sort of the base lifting off. Rocket's hacking skills and everything have done it again. He's escaping prison once more. And here is your Guardians of the Galaxy. Yeah, I had to get a picture of Ronan in here. So, because, you know, he's the main bad guy. That would be weird for me not to get a picture in. So, you know, it was sort of a commitment. This was, like, the last picture I think I added. Because I needed Ronan, and he's, like, holding out his hand saying, you're Guardians of the Galaxy, just like, you know, it's an important moment where they get their names and everything. And so, yeah. Here is another picture of Celestial Beings holding the Infinity Stone. I mean, yeah, I wasn't gonna make this calendar for Infinity War, but I figured that I might as well, you know, at least add a picture that sort of built on to the Infinity War. I didn't want to, like, totally go, like, yeah, this is not at all leading to the Infinity War, because there's a little bit of a hint to it, so I had to add an Infinity War. And it's about the orb, and so it, like, is specifically about the movie. And so, you know, they're watching this big screen, and yeah, this picture is on the most purple side of the picture, because it's the most purple. You know, and here's the star with, here's the planet with the ring. It's another ring. This one might have looked better because it's sort of off screen. What just happened there? Let's see. If I moved anything. Synchronize. I'm scared. What if I did a bad thing? So, here is when they're all holding hands, with the exception of Groot. You know, and this is when they become the Guardians of the Galaxy, although Star-Lord says a bad word. Yeah, it's sad. But, you know, they're holding the Infinity Stone together, and they're the Guardians of the Galaxy. And that's the most heroic moment in the movie. Man, what was the synchronized thing for? I don't know. Send backwards. man, this is scary. Two action. Might work. I might have did something. Redo. Redo. That actually did nothing. I might have accidentally moved the text box. So, yeah. So I'll just go and say next month's theme is total... I mean, last month's theme was totally Sonic the Hedgehog 2006! Oh, you can see a lot of stuff reflecting in Sonic's eyes, like... You know, he has very glassy eyes. I don't know. So it's Sonic the Hedgehog 2006, and so that was last month's theme. So yeah. And you got on the 29th, the 29th, and on the 30th, the 30th, and this is May, which is over now. I know this calendar is late again. So here's the first. And last, on Friday, it just passed, Wonder Woman came to theaters, and so did Captain. I'm not gonna say the last word, that's just humiliating. I put a frowny face next to it. Yeah, it's DreamWorks Animation. I'm gonna have to suffer through it. Because I watch all the DreamWorks films, unless they're, like, super bad in that one. I think only the name is so bad. And his outfit. And, yeah. But it's too cartoony to get anything over PG-13. I mean, PG, so I don't know. It's terrible. It's a terrible fate we all share. Maybe you'll enjoy it. I don't know. It just seems... to put me into... I don't know. I mean, the preview looked decenter than I expected. But yeah. It's the last DreamWorks movie until 2019. They canceled Larkins. They shouldn't have. Okay, so here's the last day of school. This is actually tomorrow by the day I'm recording this. Don't know where it'll be when I'm... Yeah, summer vacation begins on Pentecost. This is the day where the Holy Spirit came into the temple and stuff. Yeah. So, you know. Or wherever they were speaking. So it's the last day of school, and it's the beginning of summer vacation. So hopefully you enjoy summer vacation. For me, it's summer vacation. Hopefully you don't have to go through summer school, because that's sad. And here's Beauty and the Beast on DVD. It's a movie. And here is when I leave California to head to Montana to see my family for the summer. So I'm spending the summer in Montana. That's a good place to go. So yeah, best to go to Montana. And I arrive in Montana on the 9th, and I hug Mom in Montana. And as a little side note, the mummy's coming to theater. But, you know, mummy, as in my mom. But, you know, if you're interested in the mummy. But, you know, it's not as important as hugging Mom in Montana, so yeah. And then here's a strawberry festival, where Mom's talking about strawberry shortcake, but I haven't seen strawberry shortcake. I guess I'm not in the target audience. She made me watch La La Loopsy, so I went through that, and so yeah, I'm not gonna watch Strawberry Shortcake, sorry Strawberry Shortcake fans, unless we have to do another bargain, if she watches another movie, and I think into whatever, but I had to watch it on the big TV, where everybody could see me watching, yeah, It wasn't my thing. And then on the 13th, Lego Batman.
I am Batman. The movie. On DVD. I am Batman.
And yeah, it's on DVD. So if you want to see it, that's a good time to see it. And yeah. And here on the 14th is somebody's birthday, and they mentioned their birthday is on the same day as Trump, so I decided I might as well put it on there. Whether you like Trump or not, you know, it's his birthday, so, you know, I'm not going to mention if I like him or not. I really don't know, actually, so I actually did mention if I like him or not, because I don't know. You know, he's a person, so, you know, people are people. He's alive, and, yeah, just like everybody else. Hillary's a person, too, so, yeah, people are people. A person's a person, no matter how small or how no matter how presidency they are. And, yeah. And it's Flag Day also. And somebody mentioned that their birthday was on the same day as Trump, so that's why I put it there. I probably would have passed over it if I didn't know. And here is a great movie that I'm looking forward to. Cars 3. I'm going to make my mom see it in theaters, and there's a very important reason why. I mean, there's no way we can miss this, or I'm in big trouble. Because if I miss this in theaters, there is a big problem. You might find out pretty soon, because, you know, it's not even in theaters. And so, yeah. But it's really important that I see it. Or I'm going to be in big trouble. And I'll let you know that, BAM! This is my desktop background and everything, and I've actually only seen one teaser for it. Yeah, I don't like watching Pixar previews. Like, if you saw the one for Good Dinosaur, it basically revealed the whole movie, and that sort of left me, you know, feeling like nothing happened when I saw it in theaters. It was like, oh my, what did I do? I just... You know, nothing happened that was new because the preview revealed it all and all the TV spots and everything. So, yeah. It's Pixar's 18th movie. And here's Father's Day. You know. And. Yeah. And here is the actual first day of summer. It's not when summer vacation begins. That begins quite a bit earlier. But this is summer solstice. Which, is technically the first day of summer, but why does it start when days get shorter? I don't know. It's... Yeah, summer starts when days start getting shorter. That's weird. And then here's the untitled Lego Brogy video on YouTube. Maybe it'll be on the 24th. This is when my brother finishes up his Lego video. He wants to make a Lego video. He has it all scheduled, and he... I don't know what... I don't know anything about it. We're just going to Montana, and I'm going to, you know, conform to his will, or whatever, and we're gonna make it. And, yeah, he's gonna, you know, we're just gonna, he has it all scheduled out, and hopefully we get it done then. And so, watch for my other channel, if you know my other channel, and, yeah, you should find it, hopefully. And the 24th, the 25th, the 26th, and here's a Power Rangers movie on DVD. So if you've watched Power Rangers, you might like it. If you haven't watched Power Rangers, you might not like it. And if you have seen Power Rangers, you might not like it anyway. And if you haven't seen it, you might like it anyway. So whatever. There's some options or some other options, and it's blah, blah, blah. I don't know if it's blah, blah, blah. But I don't know. I haven't seen it, so I don't know. And then here's Despicable Me 3 in theaters. Okay, so Despicable Me 3. I don't know. The second one just felt like it was lacking something. The first one had a lot of heart to it, and I don't know, the second one just felt void or something of it. I don't know, the second one wasn't terrible, but it just felt like it was missing something. It felt like it was missing the heart of the first one, so I don't know if the third one's gonna do any better or not. I don't know, but it's in theaters, and so I'll say when it comes to DVD, probably. Yeah. And so, here we have next month's theme. I'm about to reveal it, and you'll understand a great many things, like... Cars 3! Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Now you realize why me and Mom are gonna have to see it, or I'm in huge trouble, because, you know, if we don't see it, then I'm gonna be in a big problem next month when I make my monthly calendar, because I haven't seen the movie... And I haven't seen the trailers either. I've only seen the trailer. And so it's like, I have no idea what this is about. And so, you know, I know it's hopefully going to be good. I have a few ideas of what it's about. But it's like, if I don't see Cars 3, then I'm doomed with my next monthly calendar. I did the same thing before with Monsters University before. But it was actually out when I said next month's theme. I just hadn't seen it. This is a risk because it hasn't even come out yet, so who knows if Pixar will be destroyed and it never gets out. That would be depressing, and, you know, lots of people would be destroyed. That would be super depressing. Yeah, but, you know, there's still, like, a little, just almost 2 weeks until it comes out, so there's not even a guarantee that Cars 3 will exist in the future. And so, yeah. Hopefully it does, because that would be super depressing if it doesn't, because it's so close. But yeah, that was my June 2017 calendar, The Guardians of the Galaxy. The Guardians of Gahool. Whatever. No, it's Guardians of the Galaxy, but you know. So this is the Guardians of the Galaxy calendar, and yeah. Hopefully you enjoyed. I don't know if I sounded depressed or not throughout most of the calendar. I sounded more jolly than I thought I would, but I said I would be depressed, and I still am. But yeah, that was Guardians of the Galaxy calendar, June 2017. Hope you enjoyed. Bye!